Hey folks, how are you? Hillary here, and I have a question for you that may seem like a rhetorical question, but really and truly, if you rented some space in a mall, set it up, got an interior designer, decorated, and did all of those fancy things, and then you decided that, you know what, you're only going to show up once a week, how successful do you think your business is going to be? And are you gonna ever do something like that? Pretty much, okay? And today what I'm sharing is, again, from personal experience, from the user standpoint of social media, about why it is that businesses really need to keep on top of their social media from the standpoint of actually gaining customers, okay? Social media is now the place where your customers are looking for you, finding you, if not on the social web as a whole, all right, but especially on social media. And if you take the time, energy, and effort to set up a Facebook fan page, to set up all of this, but you're not actually there, like in the mall, at the cash register, helping customers close the sale, then it's pointless, all right? So today I'm gonna be sharing a couple tips that I've found personally and also for my clients that help in terms of staying on top of their social media, all right? So for those of you who don't know me, my name is Hillary. I'm the marketing mom. I'm a social media manager, digital marketing strategist, an online business coach and trainer, and I love working particularly with moms who want to start marketing their business online, whether it is a network marketing business that they're in and they're just tired of doing all the driving to home parties and all of that stuff, and they want to learn how to really market their business online. Or if you're a solopreneur like myself and you're trying to figure out this whole world, this forest, I call it, of online marketing and social media, I'm your girl, and I'm here to help you and guide you through that process. For those of you who want to get in right now into our Facebook bootcamp, the link is in the description of this video, and you could always go and sign up. It's a 12-month course that you can sign up with me, that we do one-on-one coaching. Well, not one-on-one, but group coaching together, but you're here with me, and I'm guiding you through the process. So back to today's topic, all right? How to stay on top of your social media. So the reason I'm talking about this is because from a consumer standpoint, recently I tried to contact a couple companies online on Facebook. They've got a Facebook page. I went and I looked at all of their stuff and their products, and I said to myself, okay, I want to get in touch with them. I messaged them, and naturally everybody's got a bot, right? So I immediately got a response from their bot saying, you know, we try to get in touch with you as soon as possible, blah, 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 whatever the case may be. So that I just did a thumbs up and I was like, okay, great, they'll be in touch with me soon. All right. A couple of days later, I didn't hear back from them. So I went back to their page and I clicked on the call to action button. All right. On your page, you know that you have the ability to put a call to action button. It could be a call me, it could be message me, it could be send me an email, it could be sign up. Facebook gives you a range of options for that call to action button on your page, okay? If you click on mine, all right, you're probably going to get a sign up or register, okay? But the point of the matter is you've got those options to be able to connect with people, all right? So I went back to their page and I clicked on the call now button. So I got the phone number, I called. The phone number is out of service, okay? So our first thing is, one, we message them, the bot answers me. And because I'm in social media, I know it's a bot. So they've got that set up just to keep their response time up, great. But then 3 days later, I still haven't gotten an actual person responding to me. And then when we go back to the page, the only other way to connect with them, which is via phone call, is not updated. The phone number is not updated on their page. So again, back to the analogy of our mall. Would you go into a mall, rent space, set it up, and do everything, and then literally have it closed for 24 hours a day? No, you wouldn't. And this is the point with social media. If you're gonna set up your page, if you're gonna do social media, make sure that you're there. Now, your question is probably then, how the hell am I going to be there 24/7 to answer responses? Well, these are the things that have worked for me, all right? They've worked for me in the past, and they work for me with my clients as well. and they are simple little tools. Okay, so I'm going to break them down for you. A lot of people think that social media is just pushing out content. And yes, that's great. You've got to plan your content. A lot of people, when you go to a Facebook page, it's dead. The last post was maybe 4 months ago or something like that, because there's been no planning of content ahead of time. I always recommend once a week, sit down and literally block yourself out. Put on blinders, block yourself, and plan your content for a week, an entire week. Whether it's you're just planning for one post a day, two posts a day, plan it out. Pull everything you're going to need for that and have it ready to go. Okay, so that's one thing, planning content. And literally, depending on how much content you want to share on your social media pages or how little, that could take you anywhere from 30 minutes to an hour for a week. Guess what? And you'll be done after that week. Okay, so the next thing, which is crucial, and this is something that you've got to do daily. Daily, set aside 15 to 20 minutes morning and evening. Now that's important, morning and evening. Again, if you have a social media page, you can't just put it up there. It's not a flyer that you put on your college notice board and you left it. I mean, for those of you who remember those, all right? Remember when you went to the college notice board and they have those little things that you pull down with somebody's phone number for you to contact them? Remember how crowded that got, and eventually you couldn't even find your own if you went back a week later? Okay, so you've got to keep up with your notifications, your messages, all right? So I always recommend block 15 minutes morning and evening. We're all busy, we're moms, and you know, we've got our businesses to run, we've got our families to take care of, but you need to sit down for 15 minutes, make it your cup of coffee, all right? You have a cup of coffee, you sit down for 15 minutes, you're sipping that cup of coffee, and you're going through your notifications. Who liked, who commented, who sent me a message, and respond right there and then. Now, why do I say only 15 to 20 minutes? Because you want to be literally have tunnel vision when it comes to responding to these comments, notifications, likes. You want to have tunnel vision, because what happens a lot of the time, we're on Facebook, our business page is on Facebook, and then you just get sucked into Facebook. So in order for you to not get sucked into Facebook, this is one bonus recommendation that I do recommend, is that you do your stuff inside a business manager. That way you don't see anything else going on Facebook. You're not distracted by it. You're inside business manager responding to notifications and messages. And then when you close it down, you're done. All right. Again, you do it 15 minutes, 15 to 20 minutes in the evening, you know, after you put the kids to bed or whatever the case may be, just to make sure you didn't miss anything during the day. And then first thing in the morning, you come back, because, you know, there's some people who are like night owls, you know, like we wake up like jumbies at 3 a.m. in the morning. All right. And we do all our work then. Okay. The next thing to get on top of is going inside of groups. And again, the way you're going to get on top of a lot of things and even get clients. Now, this is something that may be a little different, is spending a little time in the groups that you're involved in. So maybe you're involved in groups where there are other mothers or whatever the case may be, all right, where you can actually find contacts. You want to spend some time in those groups and answer questions. Answer questions. Just go in there and answer questions. You're not going in there to sell. You're not going in there to pitch. You're going in there to answer questions, okay? And again, this is something that maybe, because of a time crunch, you don't want to do it daily, but it should be done at least once a week. At least once a week, so that the people in your group know that you're alive, you have a heartbeat, and that you are somebody who has answers to their questions, okay? And the last thing, which is more of the response time, and I kind of covered this inside of tip two, all right, where we talked about just responding to those notifications and messages. If you schedule that on your calendar every day, and that's something that you want to do daily, 15 to 20 minutes in the morning, 15 to 20 minutes in the evening, what you will find is that you are able to respond to people within 12 hours. It's kind of like a rule of thumb, you know, it's not like you're sitting down on your phone and waiting for messages to come in. We get it. You've got a business to run. But at the end of the day, people generally want a response in less than 6 hours, to be quite honest, in less than 3 hours. But rule of thumb, 12 hours, people are going to be like, okay, that's within, you know, some reasonable time frame. If you can get a response within 8 hours, that's even better, okay? But realistically speaking, don't let 24 hours pass without responding to somebody. It's the same way you don't let 24 hours pass on your store and the mall didn't open, okay? Let's think about it that way. Okay, so I hope you've gotten value from this. If you know anybody who would benefit from this, again, I also have the link to our Facebook bootcamp, social media bootcamp. It's not limited to Facebook, but I mean, it is a Facebook bootcamp, 12-month course. You can always grab the link inside of the description of this video. And if you just want to talk social media, sign up for a free strategy session with me and we can get started there, okay? That link is also in the description, but it's hilarydefreitas.com/strategy. If you know somebody who really needed to hear this, how can they stay on top of their social media, definitely share this video, like my page, and also turn on notifications so you can get the notice when I go live, okay? Have a great afternoon, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye, everybody.